There's a 1, 2.
Francis Drake and his band of sailors and escaped black slaves descended from the mountain ridge at the heights of the Continental Divide at Cerro Brewster, and they crossed the savannah grasslands, which they called Champion Country. And from there, they could see this fabled city in the distance, backed by what we call the Pacific Ocean. In Drake's day, it was called the South Sea. And Drake camped on a hill about half a mile behind the camera. He had arrived at Spain's crossroads of the New World. This was a shipment point for merchandise flowing from the gold and silver mines in South America. It was stored here and put onto packed trains and taken across the Isthmus of Panama. And Drake was the first Englishman with this idea to get rich by robbing one of these mule trains. He sent one of his slaves into the city to find out when the next mule train was leaving. And this escaped slave from the Spanish Empire told Drake that there was a mule train leaving that evening, headed by the retired treasurer of Lima, Peru, with his pension fund in saddlebags in the shape of gold bars. And Drake hastily marched towards the interior of the country about 18 miles further north to set his ambush at midnight. Drake returned home from this voyage when he was here in 1573, where he would have seen these buildings. That convent was only a year old in Drake's day, the tower behind me. He had another association with Panama. This city was receiving all the news of his robberies from the ships that he captured between Chile and here in 1579 on his world voyage, and the escaped, the released prisoners would give their versions to the judges, and these depositions will be sent to King Philip of Spain. And the third and final association Drake had with Panama City was on his last voyage. When he captured a town called Nombre de Dios on the north coast, he sent his soldiers inward to capture this city, but they were repulsed at the Caparilla Pass. And it was Drake's dream to actually capture this city and strangle Spain's supply of silver from the mines of South America, making Spain poorer and making England richer. But Drake was ahead of his time. How on earth was he going to reinforce and fortify his position here when he had to bring supplies and troops constantly across 50 miles of jungle? It was this thinking that made Drake the radical sailor, seaman, politician of his day. And this brings us to the end of this part of the video. Thank you for your watching.